what if we look at how charges redistribute when they're not touching each other? Okay. And this, I'm not going to worry about numbers. I'm going to say that I've got a neutral conductive ball right there, steel ball. And I bring a really strong, positively charged object. What will happen is charges will move in that conductor. How will they move? The electric field is this way, electrons will move this way, so you end up having more electrons than protons on that side and more protons than electrons on this side. I'm not going to say it every time, but I will say there are still a ton of protons over here and a ton of protons over here and a ton of electrons over here, but there are more electrons than protons over here. More protons than electrons over here. There are excess electrons there, excess protons there. And other protons that have been left behind when the some of the electrons moved over. That's called polarization. That's when an object has one polarity of charge on one side and one polarity on the other side, different polarity. So it's kind of like charge separation. Well, guess what's going to happen here? If we think of Coulomb's law, what ends up happening is these have a smaller r. The distance from here to here is smaller than the distance from here to there. So these are going to repel. This plus and this plus, this side of the ball and this side of the ball, they will repel. So there's going to be a little force there repelled by this. These are closer. Remember, 1 over r squared, closer is a kind of a powerful thing. This side is going to be more strongly attracted than this side. So we'll end up being drawn towards this. So even though this is neutral, that's a way that neutral objects can have an attraction to a charged object. It's not a violation of our rules. What happened was the electrons got drawn over. They're now closer to the positive charge than the unmatched protons are over here. Since they're closer, 1 over r squared, they end up being more strongly attracted than these repel. Okay? The same thing would happen if I brought a negative charge. The electrons would move away. Unmatched protons here would be attracted. So basically a neutral object, if it can polarize, is going to be attracted to a charged object. Okay? An example of that where you see it, I'm sure you've seen it a whole bunch of times, is a balloon. You rub a balloon on your hair and then you can stick it to the wall. Okay, here's the wall, here's the balloon. When you rub the balloon on your hair, you end up getting a net negative charge on the balloon. In fact, it's like that. It's not a conductor. The wall is not a conductor. So if electrons can't move from one part of the wall to the other part of the wall, why do they stick? If the wall's neutral and it is not a conductor, well, what happens is at the atomic level, let's just pretend these are the atoms. Okay. At the atomic level, you've got protons, a bunch of protons in the nucleus. What happens is these electrons push electrons away. So you end up having electrons. It's not actually like they move to the other side of the atom. They just tend to spend a little more time on the far side of the atom. That's not a big
distance. Ebenezer, Josephine, Mr. Anno, do you report in the small gym? Wabina, Yadon, Ebenezer, Josephine, Mr. Anno. Thank you.
So this wall that's neutral and this balloon that's negative, the electrons can't move freely. But what happens is at the atomic level, very small distances, the electrons spend more time over on that side of the atom. So, there is a slightly bigger attraction, and really it's mutual attraction, between the nuclei and the electrons in the balloon than there is repulsion from the electrons in the atoms in the wall
and the electrons in the balloon.
So there's slightly, they're a little tiny, tiny bit
closer. So
this attraction of plus to minus kind of dominates that dynamic.
Now, that polarization is so small, right? It's only at the atomic level, and it's only electrons spending a little more time at the other side of the atom, that this is a really, really weak attraction. And you can see, if I just throw a balloon up here, rub it on my scant hair, throw it up in the air, it's not going to go, ooh, bam, it's not going to get pulled in there. But if you rub it and you put it right on there, so they're very, very close to those atoms, to those nuclei, then you end up having that attraction. That is still polarization, and that is another example, in this case, of a non-conductor being trapped. Neutral non-conductor being attracted to a negative non-conductor, but charged. So you can have polarization in the macro level when you're talking about conductors, where the charges move from one side to the other. Not all of them, some of them. Or you can have polarization at the atomic level, which is much weaker dynamic for Coulomb's law forces.